an interesting and fun part of the process is to point out what you did wrong, what I did wrong, so that I could get better than that.
Yeah, I think bombing is more important in comedy than being funny, because you don't learn your mistakes. You don't learn, you know, it's like you move out of your mom's house for the first time and you forget to pay your light bill and the lights get cut. And you're like, why are my lights out? Because you didn't pay your light bill. I'm supposed to pay a light bill? But now you've learned, like, shit, every month I got to make sure I pay Duke Energy. That's comedy. It's comedians who swear they'd never bomb. I've seen them bomb. They swear to never bomb. And when you bomb, you know that, okay, so this crowd, this type of crowd didn't like my energy. This type of crowd didn't like the way that I said fuck too many times. This type of crowd don't like dirty. This type of crowd didn't want clean. You learn that by bombing. A lot of comedians so busy, they tell you how much they killed on social media, which as comics, we love the bomb story.
Yeah.
The bomb story is the best story, bro. Because we always kill. The kill story, hey, man, I murdered last night. No, walk in the motherfucker and tell me, hey, bro, I bombed so bad they had to escort me out the back. Them people wanted their money back. Like, that's the story that as comics, we want to sit down here and have a good time. Because you're supposed to kill. That's the thing. You're not supposed to bomb. So when you bomb, the bomb story is always the best.
And it's the education of how to freeze the point where you notice that you're bombing and turn it around so that you're doing well. Like, yeah. That's why we bomb, it so that you can figure out how to get out of that and not do it. Yeah.
You hit on the head. You said the test. You fail a test in school. You get to retake it. You get to retake it sometimes. So you bomb on Monday. You get to retake that test on Tuesday at another open mic. Let's try it again. But the thing about bombing in comedy and failing in class, you can fail in class too much, your ass get put back. In comedy, you can keep bombing, and eventually, hopefully, you're going to pass that set. And it's going to be a good set. That's the thing about comedy. I tell every young comic, you're going to struggle early. If you're a new comic and you're watching this and you're like, man, I just can't find my voice, what the hell? You're going to struggle. 9 times out of 10, most comics don't start out being super funny. They don't. You have to keep working there. You're going to bomb. You're going to bomb. And one day, bro, you're going to find your voice. I'm going to tell y'all this story, and I mean this from the bottom of my heart. Mike Charette, if any of you guys ever met Mike Charette or know Mike C, and I tell him this story, was one of the worst comedians I've ever seen in my life. For a year and a half at Other Bar Open Mic, that boy bombed every Monday. One Monday, I'm outside and somebody is killing. I'm talking about killing to the point where somebody ran out the door that we had locked. They unlocked the door, ran out, ran back in, locked the door. I said, who in there killing? I walked in and goddamn it was Mike Charette. He found his voice. He found his voice. And after that, he's one of my favorite young comics, bro. And after that, he was consistent. He knew who he was. He knew the type of comedy he wanted to do because he was trying all kind of different stuff. He finally found his voice. Now, it took him a year, year and a half, 2 years. Some comics, it might take you 5. That's fine. You ain't making no money in 5 years any damn way. So, so some comics, it might be 10. If you're really into this, it may take you a year or two, 3 years, 4 or 5 years. If you're really into this, you keep trying, you keep working at it. One day you're going to find your voice and somebody's going to run out that door laughing at something you said. And I'm going to be like, well, goddamn, Richie found his voice. Good for that kid.
I'm still looking.